On this week's show, making the Tesla Model S P85D look slow, powering cars with cow poop, and how Elon Musk nearly sold Tesla to Google 2 years ago for $6 billion. These stories and more coming up next on T.E.N. Enjoying today's show on YouTube but want to read the stories in full we're referencing today? You've got two choices. Either click on the information bar for each story as you're watching, which will take you to the relevant story directly, or head to our website at www.transportevolve.com, where you can find the show notes for today's show and all previous shows for your reading pleasure. It's Friday, April 24th, 2015. I'm Nikki Gordon-Bloomfield, and I'm filming this outside today in honour of Earth Day. I must be mad. Last week, we brought you news that GM had begun to offer some big discounts on the 2015 model year Chevy Spark EV, ahead of next year's planned debut of the 200-plus mile Chevrolet Bolt electric car. Well, today it's the turn of the first generation Chevy Volt range extended EV, which will be getting its own set of price cuts as Chevrolet dealers try to clear some 200-plus days worth of first generation Volts it has in its inventory ahead of the August launch of the second generation model. As we reported on Tuesday, those wanting a 2015 Volt can now get a $2,500 cash-on-hood rebate when buying this outgoing model this month, while those opting to lease can have one for just $249 per month, with $500 due at signing. Come to Chevy for the first time and there's an additional $500 discount available, giving you nothing to play at signing. Of course, the new 2016 model year Volt will have better range, efficiency and more seats than the first generation model. But if you're on the lookout for a bargain, you may want to visit your Chevy dealership now. It's happened, and it's happened 2 years ahead of target. Norway has just sold its 50,000th electric car, yet again showing the rest of the world that electric cars don't have to be a niche market vehicle. The 50,000th car, a brand new Tesla Model S, means that Norway has reached the EV adoption target it set itself for 2017, well ahead of schedule, and it's already prompted Norwegians to try and decide what happens next. At the moment, electric cars get some pretty decent perks, including driving in the bus lanes, free parking and charging in major cities, and zero sales tax. But the cost to national budget, between $384 million and $512 million, means that Norway could find itself reducing those generous incentives now that electric cars have become part of everyday life. We and the rest of the world will be watching to see what happens next, and more importantly, if Norway keeps at the forefront of plug-in advocacy or not. With a 0-62 miles per hour time of just 3.1 seconds, the Tesla Model S P85D, Tesla Motors' flagship all-wheel drive variant of its popular Model S electric sedan, is one of the fastest cars around. And as a consequence, there's little that can keep up to it on the drag strip, electric or otherwise. But this week, Italian motorcycle manufacturer Energica released a video of its 2015 Energica Ego electric superbike taking on a variety of high-performance vehicles, including the Tesla Model S P85D, in a straight-line drag race. With 100, yes, 100 kilowatts powering the rear wheels, the Energica Eco can reach 62 miles per hour in 3 seconds, marginally faster than the Tesla Model S, and just received its official approval this week to go on sale in the US in the fall. I want to go. Like rival Tier 1 automotive parts supplier Delphi, German parts and electronics company Bosch is working hard to develop and test autonomous driving technology. To that end, it's recently released a video in which it gives us a sneak peek at what living with an autonomous vehicle could be like in the near future. While it features concept CGI-generated images rather than actual self-driving technology, it gives us a really interesting glimpse into the near future of self-driving cars. Eagle-eyed viewers will also note that the car on which this version is based is a production Tesla Model S, with Bosch replacing all of Tesla's stock systems with its own computer-generated suggestion of what auto-drive technology could offer. For us, the most interesting feature is a route planner, which allows the driver to prioritise manual versus autonomous drive modes, allowing them to pick longer routes with more autonomous driving over shorter routes where they'd have to do more of the work. It's going to be interesting to see if this rather innovative idea takes off, because I, for one, would love it. What about you? $6 billion is a lot of money. I mean, that's more than the predicted build cost of the Tesla Gigafactory in Reno, Nevada. And it's certainly more than most of us will ever see in our lives. But this week, ahead of the launch next month of a new biographical book on Elon Musk by author Ashley Vance, comes a claim that just 2 years ago, money woes at Tesla Motors nearly resulted in Tesla CEO Elon Musk selling the Californian automaker to Google for $6 billion. As the story goes, Tesla was struggling to sell its Model S electric car and financing funds tight as it tried to fix some of the early teething problems that plagued early production Model S cars. Desperate, Musk approached Google CEO Larry Page for some help and agreed in principle to the sale of Tesla to Google. But in the intervening time, Tesla's fortunes turned around thanks to some hard work from Tesla's sales force, resulting in a welcome end of quarter profit and a massive jump in stock price. With cash in hand, Tesla no longer needed the acquisition, and the whole thing was called off. Tesla isn't commenting on the story, but we've got to admit that it's certainly a plausible recollection of what was a tough time for the company just 2 years ago. When it was first announced last year, Volvo kept official figures for its 2016 XC90 T8 plug-in hybrid close to its corporate chest, promising that it expected the luxury plug-in to get somewhere around 59 miles gallon equivalent on the US test cycle in EV mode. But this week, we've learned that Volvo's original estimates were fairly conservative, with the news from Autocar that Volvo now expects fuel economy and emissions to be much lower than previously thought. Having talked to insiders at the Shanghai Motor Show, Autocar says Volvo now expects CO2 tailpipe emissions of 49 grams per kilometre, down from 59 grams in the previous estimate, as well as official gas mileage figures somewhere around 160 miles per UK gallon on the combined NEDC plug-in hybrid test cycle. That testing method is different to the US EPA system and accounts for two-thirds electric and one-third gasoline operation, so expect US figures to be slightly different when published. Either way, better fuel efficiency is better for Volvo, and a massive shot across the bow of the Audi Q7 e-tron, whose emissions and fuel economy figures aren't expected to be as good. Let the battle of the full-size plug-in SUVs begin. Right now in the US, there are three competing standards for quick-charging electric cars. The Japanese-designed CHAdeMO system, favoured by Nissan, Mitsubishi and Kia. Tesla's proprietary supercharger standard, currently only used by Tesla's own plug-in cars. And the combined charging system, or CCS, a standard supported by a total of seven different US and European manufacturers, which was designed to be the de facto standard for all North American and European electric cars moving forwards. But as data released this week shows, CCS quick charging provision is way behind both CHAdeMO and Tesla across the US, with California, the US state with the most public charging stations in it, having more than three times the number of CHAdeMO charging stations in it to CCS charging stations. The data collected by PlugShare over the past 4 years shows that CCS charging station installation figures are about 2 years behind CHAdeMO and 1 year behind Tesla supercharger installation figures. Hopefully that's going to change thanks to a pact between Volkswagen and BMW to install more CCS-compatible charging stations along the east and west US coasts this year. But while there are certainly more CHAdeMO-compatible stations, we'd like to point out that there are also more CHAdeMO cars, so you might be actually better off buying a CCS car even though there are fewer charging points, because the queues to charge will certainly be smaller. And finally, over the years, plenty of people have called hydrogen fuel cell technology bullshit, including Tesla CEO Elon Musk. But this week, Toyota decided to use that claim in its literal form to highlight how it's possible to make hydrogen fuel from, you've guessed it, bovine byproducts. Having grown up on a dairy farm, I can tell you that cows do poop a lot. But the process of converting cow shit to hydrogen isn't all that easy or energy efficient. First, you have to let the manure settle and decompose, capturing the methane that is naturally released from that process. Then you have to reform the methane at super high temperatures near to a metal catalyst such as nickel in order to split off the carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide, and hydrogen. The process is energy intensive, and while it's renewable, we suspect there are cleaner and greener ways of powering a hydrogen fuel cell car. Still, we've got to give props to Toyota for being super enthusiastic on this one, but we smell something a little bad. Okay, I know I pulled a poo joke, but actually cow poop doesn't smell all that bad. It's pig shit you've got to worry about. You can catch us next week at the same time for another weekly news roundup, or visit our site every day at www.transportevolve.com for the latest news that's fit to print. You'll notice that we've had no live panel talk show for a few weeks now. We are bringing the show back, but as you know, there's a transatlantic move in the works and we record in a home studio. Say no more. As usual, there's been a whole lot we haven't managed to fit into today's show, including predictions for Tesla's big announcement next week, a 1 megawatt electric car that puts the super into supercar, Chevrolet's totally unobtainable but super sci-fi self-driving concept car from Shanghai, and our review of the 2014 all-electric Nissan ENV200 cargo van. So when we're done, click this link and head to our site to catch up. That's all there is to say. I'm Nikki Gordon-Bloomfield. Have a great weekend, and until next time, keep evolving.